제리 한국어 책 제목과 저자 말씀해 주시고 낭독 시작해 주세요.
셰익스피어의 오셀로입니다. 33페이지 1막 3장 33페이지부터 읽겠습니다. 브라반치오, 이리 오라 무어인, 이제 그대에게 주노라 내 온 마음으로. 그대가 이미 가지지 않았다면 절대로 그대에게 주지 않았을 것을. 너로 말하자면 얘야, 다른 자식이 또 없는 것이 정말 다행이다. 너의 도망이 나를 이리 포악하게 만드니 그들에게 족쇄를 채웠을 거 아닌가. 나는 다 했습니다, 공자. 공자, 제가 어르신 대신 말하죠. 그리고 교훈을 내려 그것이 한 발짝 한 발짝 이 연인들을 도와 어르신의 은총으로 안내하기를 바랍니다. 치료 시기를 놓쳤을 때 슬픔은 끝이 납니다. 근래 예상했던 최악을 보물었어요. 지나가버린 불행을 슬퍼하는 것은 새로운 불행을 초래하는 다음 길이죠. 운명이 가져갈 때 보존될 수 없다면 인내가 운명의 상처를 조롱할 수밖에 없는 일. 도둑 맞은 자의 미소는 도둑한테서 무언가를 도둑질하는 법. 부질없는 슬픔을 낭비하는 자 스스로를 도둑질하는 것이니. 브라반치오, 그럼 터키인들한테 키프로스를 속여 빼앗아 보라 그러시구려. 미소 짓는 한 우린 그걸 빼앗기지 않을 거 아닙니까? 교훈이나 판단을 제일 잘 견디는 자는 아무것도 견디지 않고 오로지 그것이 들려주는 자유로운 위안만을 견디는 자요. 그러나 교훈과 슬픔 둘 다 견뎌야 하는 거요. 슬픔을 치르기 위해 가난한 인내한테 빌어와야 하는 자는. 이 교훈 판단은 단쪽이로건 쓴쪽이로건 양쪽이 모두 무거우니까 애매모호하군요. 하지만 말은 말이니까 나는 아직 한 번도 들어본 적이 없소. 상처난 가슴이 귀를 통해 봉합되었다는 얘기를. 겸손이 청컨대 공자께서는 국사 의논으로 넘어가시죠. 공자, 터키인들이 아주 강력한 전투함대를 몰고 키프로스 향하고 있어. 오셀로 장군, 그곳의 견고함은 장군이 제일 잘 아실 것이오. 그리고 우리가 그곳에 매우 유능한 대체 인물을 배치해 두었으나 여론, 보다 탁월한 효과의 애인인 여론은 그대가 더 안전하다고 생각하오. 그러므로 그대는 새로운 운의 광택을 보다 거칠고 난폭한 원정으로 더럽히는 일을 마다하지 말기 바라오.
네, 1분 동안 방금 읽은 부분 정리해 주세요.
네, 지금 세 명의 지금 두 명이 공작하고 브라반치오 두 명이 나오고 오셀로는 사실 말하는 장면이 없는데 브라반치오는 오셀로의 장인어른입니다. 그러니까 근데 이제 어떻게 그 브라반치의 딸과 그 오셀로가 결혼을 했냐면은 사실은 이 딸이 야반 돈출을 한 거예요. 그래가지고 이 장인어른 브라반치오는 자기 딸이 없어진지도 모르고 있다가 밤에 누가 얘기를 해서 딱 찾아보니까 딸이 없어요. 그래서 그 딸이 어디 갔나 보니까 오셀로랑 이미 결혼을 한 거예요, 둘이서. 그래서 브라반치오는 이 귀족인데 그 흑인이죠. 오셀로가 무어인이고 흑인인데 자기 딸이 그렇게 자기 허락도 없이 야반 도주에서 무단으로 이렇게 결혼한 것에 굉장히 화를 내고 있는 상태고 지금 오셀로는 전쟁을 앞두고 이제 출전을 해야 되는데 이 공작은 그 베니스에서 제일 높은 사람이거든요. 이 공작이 이 약간 중간에서 화해 중재를 해서 화해를 시켜주는 장면이죠.
영어 낭독으로 넘어가겠습니다. 페이지
It's page 227. Brabantio, come hither, Muir. I here do give thee that with all my heart, which but thou hast already, with all my heart, I would keep from thee. For your sake, Jewel, I'm glad I chose as so, I have no other child. For thy escape will teach me tyranny to hang clogs on them. I have done, my lord. Duke, let me speak like yourself and lay a sentence, which is a grace or step may help these lovers into your favor. When the remedies are passed, the griefs are ended by seeing the worst, which late on hopes depended. To mourn a mischief that is past and gone is the next way to draw new mischief on. What cannot be preserved when fortune takes patience her injury or mockery makes. The robbed that smiles steals something from the thief, he's robs himself that spends a bootless grief. Brabantio, so let the Turk of Cyprus be us beguile, we lose it not so long as we can smile. He bears the sentence well that nothing bears, but the free compote which from thence he bears. But he bears both the sentence and the sorrow that to pay grief must a poor patient borrow. These sentences to sugar or to gall, being strong on both sides, are equivocal. But words are words. I never yet did hear that the bruised heart was pierced through the ear. I humbly beseech you, proceed to the affairs of the state. Duke, the Turk with the most mighty preparation makes for Cyprus. Othello, the fortitude of the place is best known to you, and though we have there a substitute of most allowed sufficiency, in opinion, a more sovereign mistress of effects throws a more safe voice on you. You must, therefore, be content to slaver the gloss of your new fortunes with this more stubborn and boisterous expedition.
Jerry, what is an important word in this page, in this part?
Well, there are several words that I think are important. One, the first one is a smile, because I like the words. It's a fifth line from the bottom. The rob that smiles steals something from the thief. The first word is smile. The second word that I think is important is a sentence. Sentence is the first line of the second page. He bears a sentence well, that nothing bears. So these are the words that I think are important.
Why do you think they are important?
Well, Duke is giving sort of, he's trying to make out peace between those Brabantio and Othello. And he's using kind of maxim. And those maxims, one of the first maxims is about smile. You should smile when you are faced with difficulty. But Brabantio also counters the maxim, like, you have to, it's easy for you to, easy to say, but it's not that easy, because it's you have to bear the grief. So that maxim is, here the sentence means the maxim about smiles, thief, everything. So they're kind of playing on the words, so I think that's why the sentence or the smile is very important to us.
What page are you going to explain?
Well, before that, Jerry, use a commented maxim. Mm-hmm. So for junior members, could you explain the meaning of maxim? I think it's very important word.
Yes, maxim is words like sentence that has a lesson in life. For example, heaven helps those who help themselves. Those are great example of maxims. So, and his maxim, Duke's maxim here is the rob that smiles steals something from the thief. That's his maxim that he gives to Brabantio.
Yes, my maxim is do your job, get what you like. Uh-huh. And this is my maxim. Yes,
okay, yes. Any questions?
Moor is which country?
Moor, I think it's northern Africa part of, northern Africa. So I'm not too sure, but so when you are Moor, that means you're black from the Africa. But Othello is a black, but he's basically a royal person, descended from kings, yes, who's in very high position.
Can I help you? The Moor is a people who came from the, as he said, North Africa, Islamist, and then since the 700s, and the Iberia, the peninsula, the Spain, and was conquered by Islamist, and then those people who conquered before the Isabel, and then so who supported the Columbus, and then before then, and after 770, blah blah, like that. And the people who conquered the Iberia Peninsula, the southern part of the Spain. Mm-hmm. Just ask him the storytelling.
So, which page are you going to explain?
Oh, okay. So I was going to explain the the part about the maxim. So let me start with the maxim about the robbed. So it's a fifth line from the bottom on the first page. The robbed, the smile steals something from the thief. I think it's pretty obvious, but the robbed means robbed people. So let's say you are robbed. Robber comes to you and threatens you, and you have to like give him money, whatever he got. But you still, when you smile, when you get robbed, which is, I think it's quite impossible, but yeah, when you have that peace of mind that you're, in a way, you're stealing something from the thief, right? So I think this maxim stresses the importance of like having peace of mind, even when you get like robbed, yeah, and you have difficulty. The next, and he robs himself that spends a bootless grief. Here, bootless means pointless. So he robs himself that spends a bootless grief. That means that those, after being robbed, if you spend too much time grieving about what happened, like say, you could say, oh, I'm so sad, but then it's pointless. Yeah, it's no use crying over the spilled milk, they say, right? Yes, things like that. So Duke is basically saying, Othello already took your daughter, so don't get sad too much about it. Yeah, it's what's done is done. And Brabantio still counters the maxim with another maxim, which is the first two sentences, first three sentences, I think. He bears the sentence well that nothing bears but the free comfort which from thence he bears, but he bears both the sentence and the sorrow. So it basically is very difficult. The syntax is very difficult. It's hard to understand. I had to read many times to understand these sentence. But what he's saying is that it's easy for others to say, okay, so don't get too sad, yeah? But those who get, for example, who got robbed, have to bear the grief himself, right? The others, then they don't have to get sad. They just can just sympathize, right? But that doesn't help him very much. So after all, those who got robbed or who get like difficulties have to bear the grief himself, and he has to endure, he has to have patience, and he has to come over it himself. So Brabantio is basically saying that it's for you too easy to say, but it's me who has to bear the grief. So yeah, he's like kind of angry about him and countering the maxim with maxim.
So you said that Othello got married to, what's her name?
Desdemona.
Desdemona.
Yeah, Desdemona. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So how did they meet each other for the first time?
That's a very good question. Because Brabantio is a very senior council member. So he has power, and he, of course, in Othello is a very very well-known general. So he invited the general to his house, and Othello would tell his stories, like a war stories, his life stories, to Brabantio and his daughter. And his daughter kind of fell in love with the general, who told him about his life story, which was, I think it was very like captivating and very exciting, things like that. Maybe she thought very like she had compassion for this, like, because Othello went through many things. He fought many wars, and he went through many difficulties, and they fell in love. Yeah, that's all.
Can you explain the personality of Othello?
Othello?
Yeah.
I think Othello is a very straight man. And, well, you'll see what I mean when he reads his sentences. But is basically very straight and is very being kind of being honest, and he's very competent, able, but he's when he sets his mind, he doesn't like to compromise. So what's done is done. I love your daughter, so that's done. That's it. Yeah, that kind of character. But he's a very good speaker too. Yeah.
I have a question. Why Brahman Teo didn't allow his daughter married with Osanu?
What happened was, I think the daughter expected his father not to allow to marry Othello, so she just ran away. So that she ran away without his father, her father knowing. So basically, her father didn't know anything.
It seems that they were going to have a battle with Turkey. Why was it happening?
I think Venice, I'm not too sure about things that, but I think Venice owned the place in near Cyprus. So Venice was a very strong country, not a country, but a very small state, but it was very powerful. I think it had some sovereignty over one of those islands in Cyprus, and the Turkish wanted to take it. So, and the Venice went hire some very, because it was a very rich state, so he hired Othello from Moor to defend their island, as far as I know. Brahman Teo, I think I can understand what he feels. So, well, I would probably be very angry if my mother, my daughter, like gets married to, well, like general, even though he's a very famous and very able general, without my knowing. So, I can fully understand. And he's very, I think his Brahman Teo is being very reasonable at this time. Like he's not losing his temper, and he's, because they're having a war, and the state of Venice needs general like Othello, so he's letting things go. But I think he would be still angry, of course.
Why was he against the marriage between Desdemona and Othello?
I'm not too sure. But in the beginning, what would happen if he'd known, like, if Othello came to Brahman Teo and tell him that I want to marry your daughter, and how he reacted, I don't know. But in the other parts of the text, he's basically against, he's discriminating against black people, because yeah, he has some prejudices, and he doesn't want his white daughter to marry black guy. So I think things are still like that in many parts of the country, like even in the States, I think.
Brian, do you have any questions?
Okay, but Desdemona, she fell in love with Othello,
yes.
And you said that this racism,
uh-huh.
As her father,
uh-huh.
Definitely I think is possible,
uh-huh.
Yeah, right? And then Alexandre Dumas, and who wrote the Count of Monte Cristo, okay? He was a black, his father was a very famous general under the Napoleon, and his skin color is black. And they discriminate, okay, right? It's right. The same thing.